Today we are going to learn about technology, innovation, and measuring instrument. This is Form 1, Chapter 1. Chapter 1 is about, let's see, a bit slow. So let's see, wait, my computer is a bit slow. Okay, so in chapter 1, we are going to learn about daily life. Already done this, science laboratory. You need to know the apparatus, what things that you need, and what are the apparatus, physical quantities. Okay, so we already learned physical quantity and their unit, the instrument, the density, and we already learned the physical quantity and the unit. The accuracy, consistency, sensitivity, and error. The density. Today we are going to learn about density, style investigation, and hopefully we can complete 1.5, 1.6, and 1.7. Okay, so now we're back to the topic. We learned page 38, right? We reach until page 38. Okay, so until here. Technology and instrument, measuring instrument. So, we can see this is something that the doctor always use, correct or not? This is what the doctor used to measure what? To measure blood pressure. Okay, so what do you mean by blood pressure? Last time when you go to measure, I don't know whether you all see it before. Now last time people that when they measure, they need to use the thing to press, wait. And due to technology advancement, now we are starting to have this. And even I have one of these in my house to measure your blood pressure. So what do you mean by blood pressure? You got blood pressure got what? Got high pressure and low pressure. Usually when you go to the clinic and check, usually most people will have high blood pressure. Is that correct or not? High blood pressure means what? If your high blood pressure means your blood, the pressure is very high. For example, this is your vein. Means in your body, there's a vein. So this is my vein, blue color one. I need to press harder. This is my, not this one. You cannot see the blue color thing, okay? Yeah. So this is the vein. And the vein, the blood will move like this. Correct or not? That's why you see in the drama, you cut here, all the blood will come out at here because got a lot of vein at here. High pressure means the blood will flow very fast. Low pressure means the blood will flow very slow. So usually for us, we want a normal lah. We don't want fast, we don't want slow. We want a normal blood pressure. So we want to have a normal blood pressure so that we can stay healthy. As you get older or you are very fat, you will eat a lot of sotong and curry. Sotong, curry, ayam, then you start to have a lot of cholesterol, here will become fat. So when it here become fat, the blood flow through will be faster. Because the hole this big mah, so full. But if you make it smaller, it will flow faster because your cholesterol stick at your vessel there. So it becomes smaller until this is very dangerous, depend on what is your sickness. Until one day it will, you small, it will break. Break. Depend on where it break. Whether you want to break in your body or break in your brain, then you will have stroke. Then you can die if this happens in your brain. Or you will paralyze, half body paralyzed or full body paralyzed of stroke. So we must be always healthy. That's why when you go to doctor always check your blood pressure first. The one later you die or what. And yeah, always exercise. Because when you exercise, your blood will flow. So your blood flow properly. When you are young, you need to learn to take care of your body. So yeah, so this one already done this. Okay, this one, we are going to learn about the density. The formula for density is mass over density tumbler. Some people like to remember use this triangle, and I think that many students like to use this triangle. For me, I like to use this one. Okay, density equals to mass divided by volume. Let's say I give a question. Okay, so this is the question that I just created. So let's look at the question. The cube has a mass of 70 gram. The volume of the cube is 200 cm cube. What is the density of the cube? So what is the answer? Okay, so for this question, how we can do this question? So the cube has 70 mass. Look at the formula. Density is equals to mass divided by volume. So 70 gram and 200. So I just put here mass divided by volume. So 70 divided by density equals to 70 divided by the volume, which is 200. Correct or not? I just follow the formula. So I cut, divided by 2, I get 10, divided by 2, I get 3.5. 3.5 divided by 10, you will get, this one you need to move in front. Oh, yeah. So it's 0.35. 0.35, what's the unit? Because here you use gram and cm. So your answer will be gram cm negative 3. Gram cm negative 3. Can or not? So let us try to do another question. For example, maybe I can say, I say the pencil, okay? The pencil has the mass of 100 gram. The volume of the pencil is 300 cm cube. What is the density of the pencil? Okay, try to do this question. So I forget to tell you one thing, that is when you go to form one, you can use calculator. Then you can use calculator. So basically, it's a good news for you. It depends on, I think maths, there's one paper can use calculator, one paper cannot use calculator. So if I'm not mistaken, science, you can bring calculator into the exam. So you can use your calculator and do. So let's try to do this question. The pencil has the mass of 100 gram. The volume of the pencil is 300 cm cube. What's the density of the pencil? So again, I use this formula. Density equals to mass over volume. So I just put D lah. D equals to mass over volume. The mass is 100 and the volume is 300. So 100 divided by 300, I will get cut. I get 1 over 3. So the answer will be 1 over 3. This one is gram, right? And then another one is cm 3. Okay, over that side. Gram cm negative 3. Okay, so this will be the final answer. Okay, can understand or not? Can do or not? But if you press your calculator, you press 1 divided by 3, sometimes you get 0.333333. So you also can write 0.333 gram cm negative 3. Okay, up to you, okay? I prefer to write like this, okay? But if you want to write 0.3333, also can. Can or not? Know how to do or not? Some students, they tend to remember by triangle. Up to you. You also can use triangle because if, for example, this one is times, this one is divide. So if you want the mass, you just use your hand to cover the mass. So it's density times volume. If you want to do the density, you just use your hand, close the density. So density equals to mass divided by volume. If you want to find volume, you use your hand, close the volume. So it means mass divided by density. up to you. You want to use the triangle or you want to use this formula, also remember. I just remember either one. I still think this one is the easiest. You just follow this one first, okay? I next time I'll need to explain to you. I think this one is the easiest. Not the easiest, this one is harder. But for long term, it is better for you because when you go to maths, you need to learn what we call it the linear equation. For example, I want to find density. Dy, I move to here, it become time. So density times volume equals to mass. So I would recommend you remember this. This is easier for you, but this one is better for your future. Okay, so just say that. Let's look at the experiment. The aim, to investigate the relationship between the mass and density in various solid rock. Okay, so basically to investigation between the mass and density. So we want to know what has the high density, what has the low. Here it didn't tell the hypothesis, but we know, we assume that copper and iron will be more than cork and wood, right? Yeah, cork is the toilet lah. Wait, I show you cork in case you all don't know. So this is a cork. Not the bad word lah. But this is a cork. We have wood, iron. We know iron and copper is heavy, but I think iron is heavier, the hypothesis. I think cork will be the lightest, correct or not? Lightest. Wood will be okay. Okay, so weigh the mass and the volume. And the volume already cut, so it's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And the density, you are going to do this experiment in your school. But now we cannot do experiment, so I give you the mass. So let's say I give you the mass. For the wood, I give you anything lah. Huh? I give you cork, I give you the mass will be 0.5 gram. Wood, I give you 0.7 gram. Iron, I give 1. Copper, I give 1.1. Copper, I give 1.7 gram. Find the density. So let's find the density. So you can try to use your calculator to do, okay? Because the number will be weird. So I wait for your answer. Okay, so this one is very easy. You need to just use your calculator. Let's see here. Density equals to mass divided by volume. Mass is 1.1, volume is 1. So let me use the calculator and try to do. So let me press 1.1 divided by 1. I will get, let's see, 1.1. So here will be 1.1. So put here 1.1. GCM. But I don't need to write GCM lah because here it's written. 1.7 divided by 1, I get 1.7. 0.5 divided by 1, I get 0.5. Wood, 0.7 divided by 1, I get 0.7. I thought here is supposed to be 2, but anyway, I forgot that they give us 1, so we just... Anything divided by 1, you get back the same number. So actually for the water, the density of water is, you got learned in standard 6, the density of water is actually 1 gram cm cube. So if lesser than zero water, it will float. So it will go up. For example, I know cork and wood will float. Cork and wood will float. Float. Why? In terms of science, you cannot say why it is floating because it's wood, it's light, then you get the wrong answer. Sometimes a light thing also will sink. Let me think, a hair. Alright, I put my hair, I put in the water. It will sink. Of course, it won't sink because if you just drop it, but if you basahkan the rambut, but the rambut will go into the water. But our hair is very light ah. Why can go inside the water? That is why in science, we must answer in terms of science. Because the density of a hair is more than the water. So the hair sink into the water. Why the cork float? You need to answer something like, because the density of the cork is lesser than the water. So let me write it down. Because the density of the cork is lesser than the water is how you're supposed to write it. And for wood, also the same. The density of the wood is lesser than water. Why the copper and iron sink? Because the density, wait a minute, because the density of the copper and the iron is higher than water. The density of water is 1. 1.1 and 1.7 is higher than water. So it will sink. If you say, because copper and iron are very heavy, then for this one, you won't get any mark. You will get wrong. Get correct. Because sometimes heavy and light is very subjective. For you, say heavy is how heavy. For me, this thing might be very heavy. My shirt heavy or not? Not heavy, my shirt. Heavy? Not heavy. But if I put in the water, my shirt will sink into the water. But how can the light thing sink into the water? Because the density of my shirt is higher than the water. So this is how we want to answer it. Put a kinder basin, observe whether it sink or float. So for this question number 4, maybe I can ask, this is the observation. So what is the observation? Maybe I can ask. So for example, what is the observation? Is something that you, your observation. In science, when we are talking about observation, is something that we can see. So what I can see is the copper and the iron will float on the water. Cork and wood will sink into, will sink. Okay? So, question. What is the relationship between mass and density if volume of all the four is the same? Okay, so what's the relationship between mass and density? So we can see that as the mass increase, the density will increase. Assuming that the volume is the same, correct or not? So the mass increase, the density will increase. Assume that the volume is the same. Okay, I know you don't understand, but you just remember and copy, okay? Because you are Form 1, mah, so there's a puzzle. But you only put 1, 2 only, you don't see the whole picture. But every time when you learn, you will put the puzzle and you will start to see the picture. So never mind, you just know what I'm just understand half or so is okay. So I should say that when the mass increase, the density will increase. Okay. Actually, I want to put a bracket here. Assume that the volume is the same. Because even if I increase the mass, I increase the volume, then it will have no effect. You get what I mean or not? If you are good in maths, if this one I increase, the volume also I increase, and there's no effect already. You get what I mean? Let's say the mass I put one, but the volume I put, let's say the mass I put 99 lah. Wow, so big or 99, but the volume I put 999999. So what is your answer? 99 divided by 99999. I get something like, how to press this? 0.0099, something like that. 0.0099. So it becomes smaller, not bigger. That is why I say the what need to be the same. The assume that the volume is the same, but the relationship is when the mass increase, the density will increase. Arrange the above solids according to their density in ascending order. What do you mean by ascending? Ascending means go up, ascend, go up. You know mathematics, right? Ascending, go up. Descending, go down. Arrange the solid according to the density in ascending order. So, how should I arrange it? So, a lot of students don't understand the question. Let us read the question again. Arrange the solid in a density in ascending. Ascending means small to big. You still remember maths? Arrange is ascending. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is ascending. 4, 3, 2, 1 is descending. So arrange in ascending. So the smallest is called, kemudian 0.7, 1.1, and number 4. So my answer should be for this one, it will be for question for number 2, ascending, start from cork, then followed by wood, followed by copper, followed by iron, ascending, small to big, ascend, go up. Like in the English word, sometimes people forget ascend, descend. You got watch descend or not? Descend, descendant. You got watch Disney, descendant. Descendant means your descendant, your son, means going down. Descendant. You know or not English, descendant. Disney also got descendant. Descendant movie like Snow White, son. And then they got the Ursula daughter. They got the, a lot of all the Snow White, Cinderella, son, something like that. So the descendant mah. Yeah, sun means go down. Ascending means go up. Ascend to heaven. Like we read religion, God ascend to heaven. We don't say God go up heaven, right? God ascend to heaven. Based on the observation in step 4, state the operational definition of density. What is the definition of density? The operational definition for density is according to observation in step 4. What is the step 4? So the definition for density is supposed to be density is mass divided by volume. So I just write down. Density is volume divided by mass. Mass divided by volume. Is it? Okay, some because you are still young, so because you are just learning science, so maybe you won't understand what is when science say in terms of relationship, right or not? When science talking about relationship, because this question about relationship. Science, when science talking about relationship, they are not talking about boy married relationship, no married relationship or single relationship. When science talking about relationship is there is a cause and effect. For example, the relationship between, let me think of a relationship, the one of the easiest relationship. If there is water therefore the plant will grow. This is a relationship. Got water means the plant will grow. Now you can test the relationship. Because science is about relationship, but you want to have a cause and effect. Let's think of another relationship. Let me think. Okay, maybe I can say, if a person eat much rice, he will become fatter. Right now, this is also a relationship. If you eat a lot of rice, you become fat. Why you want to know this? Because this is science. You don't believe me, you try. You eat every day, you put 8%, always eat rice, then he become fat. Another one is the person, you don't eat rice. So you become thin. So this is really relationship. So in this question, they say, what is the relationship between mass and density? The relationship is, when the mass increase, the density will increase. Can or not? Can get me or not? You need to think of a density. But if you don't understand, as I mentioned before, it's okay. Okay? It's okay if you don't understand. Okay? It's because when you, the more you learn, then you will continue on. It's okay. So arrange the solid according to the density in ascending small to big. That's why the answer is where's my answer? Cobalt, wood, copper, iron. Sorry, it's a bit messy. From small to big ma. Small, then go to big. Number three, based on the option, state the definition, operation density. Means what is the meaning of density? So density is mass divided by volume. So I just already put here. Density is mass divided by volume. Okay? Recall the information that you have learned in primary school. If you still can remember. Actually, it's the same thing. When you go to science, standard 1, standard 2, standard 3, standard 4. 1 to 3, you learn science. It's the same thing. Standard 3 to standard 5, you learn. It's also the same thing. Hypothesis, procedure, observation. When you go to Form 4, Form 5, it is also the same thing. Hypothesis, procedure, observation, conclusion. When you go to university, it is still the same thing. Hypothesis, procedure, conclusion. When you go to PhD, it is still the same thing. Hypothesis, procedure, and what? But of course, if you go to PhD, the question will be a lot different. You need to do your own research. Like, I don't know, let's think of a name, like maybe if you eat the medicine of XYZ, this medicine XYZ will heal cancer cell, something like that. When you go to PhD, the question won't be easy, right? We are talking about PhD. So you become doctor, you do your research and all these things. If you pass, then you got your PhD. So recall the information you learn in primary school, material that are less dense will float. Still remember or not? Less than will float. If denser, it will sink. Correct or not? You cannot say it float because it's very light. Then you get wrong. It float because it's very heavy. You get wrong. It float because it is less dense. It sink because it is denser. For example, ice will float in the surface where stone will sink. If you still remember, what you need to remember is you need to remember water. Just remember water. Water is one. Less than one will float on water. More than one will sink. Cork, water, copper. So copper down because 8 is bigger than 1 and cork is lesser than 1. The material, you can see here, the lightest one we can see here is the petrol, 0.8. Pure water is 1, sea water is 1.33. Of course, sea water is heavy. Why sea water is heavier by a bit? Yes, so the answer, why sea water is denser? Because sea water got salt. So just let me write it down. Sea water has salt. Correct or not? Because if you put the water, this water is not heavy, but I put salt inside. Kacau, 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 kacau. It's still, the water still like that, ma. But actually, the water is heavier a little bit because it is the sea water. Got the salt, then become heavier. Very good. And we have mercury, which is one of the most heavier metal. We have cork. We have ice. And we have gold, 19.3. So the heaviest is the denser is the gold. On the earth, the most dense material is not gold, but so far lah, in this list lah, so it depends on how heavy the thing is and how dense the thing is. It can be very, 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 very dense. Depend on where you are and how it compressed. I think the sun will be very, very, very dense. The sun. Of course, I know the sun is gas because sun is made of gas. I don't think you can stand on the sun because it will go down because sun is made of gas that is continually burning. But the sun is so big, the gravity is so strong. So when you stand here, you are still alive on earth. But if you can stand on the sun, I think you will like break down on the sun because the gravity of the sun will pull you so heavy and you will become so dense. And this is the center of the earth. Even center of the earth, they say it's liquid. But the hypothesis is if you can go until down, you will stand at there even though it's liquid. Because here will be so dense, the liquid is so dense that it becomes solid. And you stand at here. It's very amazing that we can compress and press one thing and it become very dense. Until you can press and press and press until it become the black hole, correct or not? You can press everything, the whole planet you press into one ball like this. The whole earth you press until one ball like this, it will become like a black hole. Because it's so dense and the gravity is so strong until it become a black hole. Not much people know yet what is black hole is really inside it or what is it of, but we know that black hole means it's a very dense gravity together in a one place. Because you know the sun explodes, it becomes the black hole. This one you will learn in Form 3 when you learn about planet. So, water. So this one makes sense if you still remember. This one is the arrange. This is cork, petrol, ice, water, copper, and mercury. Where can you find copper at home? Where can you find the copper? Copper is at the wire, the cable. I don't want to take my cable. This I think is the cable. This, if I cut out, got the gold color thing, that is copper. This is copper. Mercury, of course, is in the thermometer. Okay, thermometer, you got the thermometer. Cork, I already show you. Cork is this one. And petrol. Predict what will happen if both object put into a pail of tap water. How you see the two object? Of course, this one will float, right? The egg will, I'm not sure, I think the egg will sink because the egg is heavier. So that's it for this video. We are going to take a short break and I see you back by 8. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much. See you next time.